Now, the first pair that we're going to look at is GBP-CHF. What you can see here is Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, separated by these vertical black dotted lines. Now, if you've never seen my charts before, what you're looking at isn't intimidating. Don't get scared, I promise. It's very simple. On top, with the black candlesticks, you're seeing just exponential moving averages, EMAs. And on the bottom, you're seeing a TDI. It's an RSI with two moving averages. And what these indicators help me do is read the trend. So from Wednesday into Thursday, we saw price action pick up from 1.168 all the way up to 1.178. So you saw a really drastic move on Wednesday, top to bottom over 125 pips, right? That's about a 1% move for this pair, which in currency pair terms, 1% is a lot, especially in a day. So then coming in on Thursday and into Friday, we found a clear long bias in this pair. We saw it making structure moves, and in particular on Friday, we saw a risk-reward setup present itself off a very key price level that I want to show you how easy it was to identify it. So if you see Wednesday's high here at that 1.178 level set, and let's just draw a vertical line going across, or excuse me, horizontal line going across at that high. Now, I don't use the pin, I always use bodies to mark that. That price at 1.1788 was broken and became support from the London into New York session on Thursday. So once we then had that price as support, coming in on Friday here, if we were to reach that level and have a long biased TDI and long biased EMAs and long biased price action, which I just showed you we do, when we reach that price level, it's a logical place to be looking for long opportunities because the bias is very clear. Now we're just lining up the timing within the edge. Now, people are going to say, well, Austin, do you just buy it when it comes to the white line here? No, that's the 200 EMA. And you never just buy it just because it comes to a line or becomes a support level. It's never that simple. I don't understand how some people think they can trade just off support and resistance and make money. I don't know anyone that does that consistently and that it works for them. So what we do is we'll come down, and at this point, if you take our courses, if you go to the website in the description here, you can check out what the D1 entry is. But at this point, we're looking for D1 entries following that long bias off the significant level of the 200 EMA, and that resistance then turns support from Wednesday into Thursday and now into Friday, that black dotted line that you see. One other thing I will also throw on here is the pivot points. Right there, you can see with that white line, that's also our daily pivot point. Now, pivot points are a very basic indicator calculated using the previous day's price action. So that's based on math. That line is not some fancy indicator. It's just based on simple math that comes from the price action the previous day. So it's a very strong level in my opinion. I love math. I love the numbers. I don't like opinions. So when we reach that price level, if we have a long bias, we can actually take it to the shorter timeframes and look for risk reward just off basic market structure. So at this time, we're looking at about 6 to 7 o'clock New York time. We find what we would look for, like I said, with a D1 signal here with bullish divergence, which means our RSI, the green line on the bottom, is rising and price action is falling. Now, I just labeled that with that black line. Once we have that set, we could start to create risk reward setups looking for this to come higher. Let's say we were to look for a breakout here at the 1.1794 level. A stop loss would probably make sense, in my opinion, to go at the bottom of that structure, of that divergence, and we would look to see what type of risk reward we can get just to that 1 minute 800 EMA. The reason why I would use the 1 minute 800 EMA, if we go back to the 15 minute, is because that's the 15 minute 50 EMA. See how we're trading from the 200, which is the white line, up to the blue line here, which is that 50. When we're moving lower here on the higher timeframes, and we are, right, from the high to now setting a low of day, when we're moving lower, we want to make sure we understand that it could hit that 50 and absolutely come back down. So when we're looking for long ideas, we know that that 1 minute 800 EMA, 15 minute 50 could be an issue. But just to that level, the risk reward was 1.5, which is pretty good. This move from our first idea actually extends almost 3R. Now get this, this is where it gets interesting. If you're reading this left to right, which you've heard me talk about before, that bullish divergence off the bottom actually becomes bearish divergence here at the top, okay? That bearish divergence would tell you there's potential change coming. So what do? You wait. You don't jump in for longs right there because you know that that bearish divergence means now that's in control and we could see this come lower. So it's not a good time to be looking for longs. But if you wait, it comes back to that daily pivot, which is this white line, that same black dotted line that shows Wednesday's high, right? The breakout price. And look what you get here. More bullish divergence, right? From that RSI point to there. We can blow that up just to confirm. See how that RSI here, it's rising into there. price is actually falling if I go like this, right? Now, again, we have a bottom where we might be looking to put a stop loss if we could see structure move higher. Here's the kicker. Look at this one. It's even cleaner. You have a level then set here. So first your stop would look to go there. Then the level is set here, then here, then here, then here. Look at the higher lows. So you could wait for this to really start to pull the TDI into the buy zone, and you could be looking to go long somewhere in here, maybe with a stop like 8 or 9 pips away like that, because you know you wouldn't want it to return and retrace that structure. You just want it to continue making higher lows. And that does. I mean, here's another opportunity on this pair following that long bias, 4R on this one into the close going on into a Friday into the weekend, I should say. So those were two ideas there following the D1 entry signal, which we teach in our courses on GBP CHF. Now let's transition.